a guidance for all mankind, the best interpretation of the Holy Quran. Click it and get it.
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده تعالى ونستغفره ونستعين به ونستعيذ به من الشياطين ومن أعوان الشياطين يا أرحم الراحمين مهم أوي. It's very important for us as Muslims to understand القرآن الكريم, the message of Allah عز وجل to us. And verse number 25 in the chapter of the Kathir, سورة الأنعام, Allah سبحانه وتعالى said, ومنهم من يستمع إليك وجعلنا على قلوبهم أكنة أن يفقهوه وفي آذانهم وقرا وإن يروا كل آية لا يؤمنوا بها حتى إذا جاءوك يجادلونك يقول الذين كفروا إن هذا إلا أساطير الأولين. Look at this statement from Allah سبحانه وتعالى after he declared to us in the verse 22 and 23, 24 the conditions and what's happening to the disbelievers, to idolaters in the hellfire, in the akhirah, in the hereafter. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us why these people, they rejected al-Quran al-Kareem. Why they stood against the Holy Quran. Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling this, telling us this ayat here in this surah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, among them are those whom listen to you, O Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they listen to the Quran. But did they listen to the Quran to understand it? To believe? No, not. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, but we have covered their hearts so they understand it? It's not. And placed deafness in their ears so they listen not. And if they see all proofs, evidences, and signs of truth, they will still deny them to the point that when they argue with you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, they will say these are nothing but tales or legends from the ancients. This is what they said. Okay, now let us try to understand more details about its meaning, this ayat. These people, the idolaters, or the polytheists, or the disbelievers, they denied the Holy Quran. Not because of the Holy Quran, no. Because of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And I want to explain that to you right now. One time, Abu Sufyan, he's a Sahabi. That's before he became a Muslim. He became Muslim in Fath Mecca, in the time of Fath Mecca. Abu Sufyan, Al-Walid ibn al-Mughira, Al-Nadr ibn al-Harif, Utba ibn Rabi'a, Shaybah, his brother, ibn Rabi'a, wa Umayyah ibn Khalaf, and Umayyah ibn Khalaf, all of them they sit together. Wastami'u lil-Qur'an, wastama'u lil-Qur'an. They listen intentionally to the Qur'an. The word, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمِنْهُمْ among them who, or those who are listening to the Qur'an. مِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَسْتَمِعْ. Allah said يَسْتَمِعْ, not يَسْمَعْ. What is the difference between both? Allah said to us, فَإِذَا قُرِئَ الْقُرْآنُ فَاسْمَعُوا وَلَا فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنْصِتُوا. فَاسْتَمِعُوا, it's a big difference between فَاسْمَعُوا and فَاسْتَمِعُوا. فَاسْتَمِعُوا with تاء intentionally. But فاسمع بدون قصد. Maybe you're sitting in the bus and the driver, he put a song. I don't want to listen. I did not pay attention. But I listened. But I did not pay attention. Right? Because he forced me to listen, but I'm not giving head or attention, right? But istama'a with ta means he is listening intentionally. For these people, they used to go intentionally to listen to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam recitation, but to understand it? No. To get the hidayah, guidance? No. For arguments. To see, is there anything who can stand against Rasulullah to tell him the Quran is bad? I'm coming to the masjid not to listen to the sheikh, to understand the Quran. I'm going to try to figure out if sheikh is mistaken or not. To figure out if sheikh saying something wrong or not, to show his shame to everybody. You're not coming to the masjid then to seek hidayah or guidance. You're coming for the sake of what? Arguments. You're trying to show off. These people, they used to sit around Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to listen intentionally to his recitation to the Quran to stand against him. For what happened, all of these kuffar, they sit together and they listen to the Quran and they asked Nadr ibn al-Harith. Why Nadr ibn al-Harith? One of them, his name was Nadr, the son of al-Harith. Why? Because Nadr ibn al-Harith, that man, he used to be like the radio or the TV nowadays, there, the social media for them. He used to summarize the whole fabricated stories from the tales of the ancient before. Asatir, turrahat, khurrafat, all fabricated, tachrifation. This is my word, tachrifation, and fabricated, yeah. Stories, and he used to tell them these stories. And he used to tell them these stories. Fastamlahuha, yani istamlahuha. They used to like it. Yalla, say more, yalla, fake, all fake. And they asked another ibn al-Haris because he's experienced in this. Talking and the stories and fabricating stories and stuff like that. Fake. And they said, "Ya Nadr, what do you think about Muhammad and his, what is he saying?" He said, I see him playing with his lips, moving his lips. I think this is the asatir al-awwaleen. This is the legends or the tales of the ancient, from the ancient people before. It's all takhrif, fabricated things. This is his opinion. And Allah mentioned that. قال عليكم السلام يقول الذين كفروا إن هذا بالقرآن إلا أساطير الأولين. It's not real. فسبحان الله والوقر. الله سبحانه وتعالى said the deafness in their ears and covered, Allah covered their hearts with disbelief and deafness because of what? Why Allah سبحانه وتعالى put that deafness in their ears and covered their hearts and they cannot least understand the Quran? Because of their stubbornness. Yes, if somebody's stubborn and he doesn't want to listen, and what is in his mind is in his mind, like we say shagfa wahda, my way. In English you say my way or the highway. If either you listen to me or not, I will not listen to you. These people of Quraysh, they became like this. And they were not against the Quran, to be honest with you. I'm going to give you the proof now from the Quran. Surah Zukhruf, verse number 31. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وقالوا لولا نزل هذا القرآن على رجل من القريتين عظيم. Muhammad, he's the son of Abi Kabsha. He was the father, the husband of Halima al-Sa'diyya, the breastfeeding woman. When Rasulullah was little, she was breastfeeding him. He's from Bani Sa'd, poor man. And they used to say, Muhammad, his son. They put him down. Where Rasulullah was from Bani Hashim, son of Abdullah, Abdul Muttalib, big noble tribe. They tried to put him down, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Quran, in this verse, he said, وَقَالُوا لَوْلَا نُزِّلَ هَذَا الْقُرْآنُ عَلَى رَجُلٍ مِّنَ الْقَرْيَتَيْنِ عَظِيمٍ. If this Quran, see, they are not, in reality, they are not against the Quran. And Allah challenged them. Give me one surah, 10 verses, one verse like this Quran. They did not. Arabic is your own language. Yalla, show me. They cannot fabricate any Quran. They cannot produce this Quran. The Kalam Allah, the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For they said, if this Quran being sent to a man, a great man from Ta'if and or Mecca, we will listen to him. But Muhammad, no. See, this is their arrogance, their stubbornness. That's why, because of their stubbornness and arrogance, Allah covered their hearts with disbelief. There is no nur, light will enter their hearts, or disbelief will be out of their hearts. That's why they stay kuffar, disbelievers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. We have to understand that. They never came to Rasulullah to listen, to understand, and to believe in Iman. No. They used to listen to Rasulullah to make arguments with him. You see somebody nowadays, he's coming to social media, they said, Quran wrong, and Arabic grammar is wrong, and mistaken, and he's, who are you to talk about the Quran? You don't know nothing. And you see somebody, he doesn't know even how to make one sentence as in the proper Arabic. And he said, look, this Quran, I don't like it. You don't like it? Fasubhanallah. Fasura, Surah in general, the chapter of the cattle, Surah Al-An'am, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send it to stand against the statues, the idols, Lasnam, Al-Wathaniya, polytheists, against the shirk, putting a partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And these people, Allah said, وَإِن يَرَوْ كُلَّ آيَةٍ لَا يُؤْمِنُوا بِهَا. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show them all the evidences, signs, proofs of the prophecy of Prophet Muhammad and for the honesty of the Holy Quran, they're gonna deny it. They're gonna deny it. For example, and Allah said, Allah mean it, كل آية. كل آية, every sign. He said, كل آية means every, if you give them all the proofs, they will not listen to you. Like what? Already Rasulullah had too many miracles. Like what? The split of the moon, right? They asked Rasulullah for it. So, can you split the moon for us? We're going to believe in you, Muhammad. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَاقْتَرَبَتِ السَّاعَةُ وَانْشَقَّ الْقَمَرُ وَيَّرَوْ كُلَّ آيَةٍ يُعْرِضُوا وَيَكُولُوا سِحْرٌ مُسْتَمِرٌ سِحْرٌ مُسْتَمِرٌ. It's a magic. And half of the moon, it was above the mountain of Abu Qubais, another half above Syria, Sham. And Allah split the moon for them like this. And they denied it. The water used to come out of between the fingers of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He used to get the pot empty and he used to put his hand, water was gushing. Sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The tree was walking from its place, making sujood to Rasulullah and going back. The camel was crying to Rasulullah. Rasulullah was talking to the camel. Too many miracles. Al hasa, the small pebbles. Rasulullah used to listen to the sbih, glorifying of that small pebbles. The food in his hand used to make the sbih. Rasulullah used to listen to it. And Rasulullah ﷺ said, Wallahi, I swear by Allah, I used to know a rock in the mountain of Mecca before I go to Medina. Since I go past by this rock, the rock was to say, Salamu alaikum to Rasulullah ﷺ. Too many miracles. They denied. Allah said, even if you show them all evidences, they deny. Why they denied? Because Allah put deafness in their ears and covered their hearts with ran, disbelief, subhanAllah. In the end, they said, it's a turrahat, it's a khurafat, the tales from the ancient people. This is what they said. The Quran is like that, subhanAllah. And they stood against Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, da'wah, because of their disbelief and stubbornness. They came to Rasulullah also with arguments. What is the difference between the mu'min, the believer, the Muslim, and the disbeliever when they listen to the Quran, or when you talk about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Or when you show them miracles, there is no miracles after Rasulullah, say karama. Or when you show them the evidences or the proofs, the mu'min, whenever he's gonna look around him, he's gonna say, La ilaha illallah, La ilaha illallah. He's gonna see the greatness of Allah in his creatures everywhere. Whenever he sees something good, he says, La ilaha illallah. Allah is capable. Allah is one. Allah is the one who created this. The mu'min will say, Allah is hakim, is wise, he's the inventor. And he's gonna think, he's gonna reflect, the Muslim, the mu'min. But the kafir, the disbelievers, they are blind. See their eyes like this open, but they are blind, they cannot see. They did not get any benefits out of their, what? Allah created, give them brain, there is no benefits. Allah give them ears to listen, there is no benefits. They have deafness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them brain to think. There is no reflection, there is no thinking. The kafir is blind on the ru'ya. He sees like Rasulullah when he migrated. وَجْعَلْنَا مِنْ بَيْنَ أَيْدِهِمْ سَدًّا وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِمْ سَدًّا فَأَغْشَيْنَاهُمْ فَهُمْ لَا يُبْصِرُونَ. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was going out of his house in Hijra, and 40 strong men with their swords, he used to give dust, dirt, and he used to put above their heads. And they are opening their eyes like this, but they cannot see him. Like Umm Jamil, the wife of Abu Lahab. One time, Rasul was sitting beside Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. They sit together. And she was talking to Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, where is your friend? If I see him, I will do this and this and this and this. Rasul was sitting beside him. Subhanallah, yes. And Abu Bakr started laughing. La ilaha illallah. She was insulting Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I will do that to him if I see him. I will do that to the threatening. Rasul was sitting beside him. Allah blind her. She cannot see him. See, for these are too many miracles. This is the difference between the kafir and the subhanAllah and the mu'min. Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab, before his Islam, he was going to kill Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the house of Al-Arqam ibn Abi Al-Arqam. You know, da'wah at Mecca was 3 years secret in the beginning of Islam. Secret. And after that, Allah said, even like 3 years secret first, and Sayyidina Umar ibn Khattab was carrying his sword like 14 kilograms. Somebody told me he saw the sword of Umar ibn Khattab in Turkey, in Istanbul. the museum. 14 kilograms he sold. Imagine that somebody carrying 14 kilograms. Yes, subhanAllah. He was carrying his sword. Somebody, Muslim, asked him, where are you going, Ya Umar? He saw the evil, shar, shayateen in his face. Sayyidina Umar was very strong. Oh, if you see him, يعني, subhanAllah. Sayyidina Umar was very tall. You see him from far away as if he's riding a horse, but he was walking. His hand was going, reaching under his knees. And his shoulder was big like that. He was bald and long beard. His beard was filling his chest. It was very white with redness in his face. This is Sayyidina Umar. Marbu' if you see his, mashallah. Sayyidina Umar was going and the shayateen in his mind during that time. He was not Muslim. A man saw him, where are you going, Ya Umar? He said, I'm going to kill Muhammad. And that Muslim, he said, he was very smart. He said, instead of killing Muhammad, go see your sister. Your sister already became Muslim. And Umar said, what? And he turned his face to his sister's house. The man was very smart. He said, let him kill his sister, but not Rasulullah. It's okay. He went to her house, Fatima bint al-Khattab, his sister. He found her husband, Sa'id ibn Zayd ibn al-Khattab. They were cousins. He escaped with al-Khabbab ibn al-Arat when they know, when he knocked the door, they know he's Umar outside. They escaped. And Fatima, his sister, she was carrying Quran. Mus'haf, Surah Taha. He said, what is this? She said, this is Quran. Did you follow Muhammad? Yes, I'm a Muslim, she said. He gave her, he slapped her face and her ears was falling and the blood came out from her face. When he saw the blood in the face of his sister, he became cool. This is his sister. You know, subhanAllah, and he said, what is this? She said, this is Quran. And he said, give it to me. He said, no, you're najis, you are impure. Go wash your body. You cannot touch the Quran. And he did. And he was listening, he was reading. Sayyidina Umar, he used to know how to read. He started reciting Surah Taha, Taha ma anzalna alayka al-Quran litashqa illa tadhkiratan liman yakhsha tanzeelan liman yakhsha tanzeelan mimman khalaqa al-ard wa as-samawati al-ula ar-rahmanu 'ala al-'arshi istawa lahu ma fi as-samawati wa ma fi al-ard wa ma baynahuma wa ma tahta ath-thara wa in tajhar bil-qawli fa innahu ya'lamu as-sirra wa yakhfa Allah la ilaha illa huwa lahu al-asma'ul husna. To the end of the ayat. And he was carrying himself before he get out, became cool. Fatima's husband and al-Khabbab ibn al-Arad, they came, they were hiding themselves, they came, said, Ya Umar, are you okay? Are you cool now? Cool down, man? Listen, we heard Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam making dua. And they said, oh Allah, guide one of the two Umars and support Islam with one of the two Umars. Umar ibn al-Khattab, you, or Umar ibn Hisham, who Abu Jahl. And we wish, if you are the one, inshallah, going to get the barakah of the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Umar, he left. He turned his face to the house of Al-Arqam. Where is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? But now, is he going to become Muslim or to kill Rasulullah? He's going to become Muslim. He knocked the door, as usual. Sayyidina Hamza, the uncle of Rasulullah, Hamza Asadullah, the loin of Allah, was sitting. He said, Ya Rasulullah, leave him to me. I will kill him. I will finish him. Don't worry about Umar. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ya Hamza, no. Leave Umar to me. And subhanAllah, Rasulullah sallam opened the door. And if you see Umar, in reality, he's taller than Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But when Umar used to stand with Rasulullah beside him, you see Rasulullah taller than Umar. Maybe Sayyidina Umar, he bow out of his humbleness or something like that. He used to see Rasulullah taller than him. For Rasulullah sallam was carrying him from his clothes like that. Like three times, he was raising him up, pew, and he put him down. Three times. Umar, are you going to be Muslim or what do you want? Immediately, he said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu annaka rasul. He became Muslim. Since Umar became Muslim, he said, Ya Rasulullah, are you saying the truth or what are you doing? He said, yes, Islam is true, the religion of Allah. There is no doubt about it. He said, why you hide yourself? After 3 years, Allah sent Jibreel immediately. And he said, Fasda' bima tu'mar wa a'rid 'an al-mushrikeen. Go outside, tell everybody Islam. And don't worry about the mushrikeen. Since Umar became Muslim, Islam goes outside. After 3 years, subhanAllah. And he was fighting Quraysh himself, all from the morning to the end of the day. Until he became tired, he got one of the big people of the mushrikeen, big people of Mecca, and he put the knife on his neck. If you come close to me, I will kill him. He said, leave him. After all the day he was fighting Umar bin Khattab. My point or shahid, Umar radiallahu anhu, is Quran al-Karim, since he read it, he became Muslim immediately. See, this is a difference between somebody who want to be a mu'min, a Muslim, when he read the Quran, Quran guides him, or somebody, just he reads the Quran with deafness and cover of his heart, and just to make arguments with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the point. And brothers, the message of this ayah, don't be stubborn. Don't be arrogant. Listen, try to understand. Allah will put hidayah and nur in your heart. This is the main point of this ayah. Then you're going to get the benefit of the Quran, the barakah of the Quran, the shifa of the Quran, the mercy of the Quran, the tranquility of the Quran. Quran al-Kareem, la tanqadi ajaibuh. There is no limit for the benefits and the blessings of the Holy Quran. That's why listen, try to understand it. That's it. Jazakumullah khair, inshallah.